And with that, like, also too, when you were talking about identity and knowing who you are, I see a lot of that within, you know, whether it's the body of Christ, just in general, I think a lot of people, like, suffer from not knowing who they are, yeah. So they go out and do everything like that. I wanted to ask you your opinion on, like, you've probably heard this phrase, Christian rappers or rappers who are Christian or Christian artists and artists who are Christian. What do you feel about that? Do you agree or disagree? What's your stance on that? Are you neutral or?
So for me, I am, like, it's kind of tricky because for me personally, I have, like, a worship leadership side, mm-hmm. Where I feel there's a call there and there's an anointing to, like, the body of Christ. And then I have an artistry side that I want to be missional based. Like, I'd rather people hear that side that have never heard of God or they don't really understand it or know mm-hmm. what love is, so that I can minister there and then hear, like, grow people in Christ. So I have, like, two sides that kind of relate to both, whereas, like, some people are just kind of on the artistry side. Or, of course, if you're a worship leader, you're mainly focusing on the Christian. Mm-hmm. But I do hear this, like, debated a lot. And we talk about it at school because our schools, for you being a great musician, that has great values. And so they don't really care if you're in the secular or you're in Christian, as long as you're you and you're representing Christ wherever you're at. Like, that's great. And I agree with that. Like, it's just, like, being in ministry, whether you're a pastor or something, like, you can do that. Or you can be a doctor who is a Christian and you affect the people in your workplace. Yeah, I think it's like that. Like, with music, it doesn't matter, like, which one you're going to do because there's a place for both. We need Christian artists mm-hmm. and we need Christians that are in the industry affecting it. And so as long as, again, you are who you say you are all around and, like, mm-hmm. you are true to yourself and representing Christ the best way you possibly can in both of those places, then either one. Like, I'm not really for or against. I do think it can become too big of a deal. Like, man, just do music, whatever comes out, as long as it's truth and it's not, like, going against God's word, like, just do it. So
because kind of like where my stance is kind of on it, because the argument is a lot of times is that they don't want to get put into a box mm-hmm. and they feel like being a Christian and saying, oh, I'm a Christian artist gets you put in a box. But my whole thing is, okay, you should want to get put in a box, but it's just like, since God is who he is, he can get you outside of that box.
Right.
If you want to be, like, I was talking to last time I was in here with somebody, and we were talking about that, and he's, like, one of the best rappers on The Chosen. I don't know if you ever heard of him. Yeah, and he's, like, one of the best rappers I've ever heard, but he's truly sticking, like, oh, yeah, I don't care if I'm getting called a Christian rapper, but he has the talent to be on any stage.
Right.
So that's, like, the kind of thing I have with it, like, when it comes to putting a box, fine, put me in a box because I'm going to break out of here because my talent is bigger than that.
Mm-hmm. And people are always going to try to figure you out. And so mm-hmm. they might put you in a box, but you know what God's called you to do. And you know that things he's called you to go later might be totally outside of it. I just think don't get caught up on whether people try to fit you into something. Like, you're going to be you and they'll see, like, kind of what happens through what you do.
So when it comes to music as well, what are some of your inspirations? That, like, are you more old school, new school? Is it a lot of worship? Is it a lot of, you know, acoustic, you know, like, rock, stuff like that? Like, what are your influences?
So, like, because my style is, like, gospel, soul, R&B, and jazz.
She can play guitar, y'all. She can play guitar. She can play guitar.
I'm trying to develop that. So that's kind of, like, what I love. And so before I went to college, I was very much listening to just mainstream radio and, mm-hmm. like, R&B stuff. And kind of thankfully, when I went to college, I was immersed into a more diverse, because there's musicians who have to learn about people I've never heard of, because I'm just a singer, you kind of listen to whatever, mm-hmm. but, like, getting an appreciation for music is totally different than just listening to music. And so I kind of totally did the opposite of what most people do, whereas most people grow up and they're listening to 80s and they're listening to 70s because their parents play it. Like, I listened to some stuff, but I didn't appreciate it. Like, when my mom would play it, I'd be like, please turn that off. Like, I want to listen to whatever, like, Tori Kelly or something. And then, but now, like, all I listen to on Spotify right now are, like, 70s. I'm very into Stevie Wonder right now in my 80s. But then I do have people I've discovered on Spotify that I love. So my number one is Emily King, if you've heard of her. Leanne LaHavas, Gary Clark Jr., people like that. Yeah, and then recently, so like on the Christian side, those are kind of just positive singers.
Yeah. I was gonna ask you about another question about that too, but
yeah they're kind of in the secular, I guess. But then in Christian, I like Will Reagan. His more recent album, he's in United Pursuit. Okay. He's the lead singer for it. That's a worship band, but he's done his own stuff, and it's more like stylistic. Also, same with Josh Garrels, and then Liz Vice. She was awesome, and recently God worked out to where I got to sing a song with her, so it's crazy.
And I wanted to ask you too, like when you're talking about your different influences, how do you kind of, you know, because being a Christian, you don't want to soak up all of the different music and stuff like that. And more so recently, I've been kind of sort of, I wouldn't say lax on my approach, but I've been, you know, because every song that's secular isn't bad.
Right.
Every song that's Christian isn't good necessarily. Right. So how do you kind of find that balance, you know, being a Christian and not wanting to soak up the wrong influences relative to like money, cars, clothes, all
right.
And,
exactly.
You know, so.
Yeah, so in high school, that's when I realized kind of what I wanted to do artistry-wise, because I was listening to R&B, but like for the music, but like the lyric-wise, it's so gross and like just terrible. And I'm like, I don't want this. So, and I know there's people out there who want to listen because they like the beats, they like this type of thing, but while they're listening to it, they're getting infiltrated with that stuff, and they might not have my stance where, you know, you can kind of, okay, I don't want that, like, whatever. So I was like, they can't do anything about it because they're just a listener, whereas I'm an artist, so I can do that type of music but have, like, meaningful lyrics. And so I kind of realized in high school that that's what I wanted to do, and since it's changed more into jazz and soul and gospel, but it's definitely a fine line of, like, because I have a lot of, like, Christian friends who listen to some crazy stuff, and I'm just like, at some point that affects you. Like, the more you hear it, the more lenient you are to start saying certain things or whatever. And even if you don't know it, like, subconsciously, it is affecting you. Whether you're going to go out and do that or not, like, it affects you. And even just the negative atmosphere can affect you. Like, just this vibe.
The mood.
And so, I listen to, my secular ones are more positive. Like, they're just singing about, like, positive things. And it's just girls and they're talking.
Have you heard of Leon Bridges?
I love his new stuff.
Yeah, I've just been listening to that. That's like when I said I've been a little bit more lax, I've listened to him. Like, some songs, I'm like, okay, let me turn that. Because I'm talking about other songs, I'm like, okay.
Like, Bad Bad News, the vibe of that song.
And then Shy, what is it? Yeah, Shy, I love that song. So, yeah, definitely. Along with that, I've seen on your Instagram, I follow you on there. Along with that, I've also seen you, you know, performing a lot lately. The new single, that Love, I love that song.
Thank you.
But so with that, what are you working on lately? Is there anything that you can tell me about? I saw you post something yesterday, something like that, like you have some new music coming. Yeah. So is it an album project? Please be an album.
Not yet an album, but it is a single.
Okay.
But it's actually one you've heard before, so it's Only You, but like revisited with a band, because I love that song. And it, when it's on that EP was kind of rushed, and like it's just me and the guitar. Back when I didn't even know what I was doing on guitar, so it's like kind of. But it was great for what it was, and I'm thankful for the opportunity. But I've always wanted to redo that one, and we did it my freshman year in college, but we never finished it or like uploaded it to anything. So redid it with a band as kind of my last thing in Memphis, and with some people and very talented musicians. And so it's a full band, and it'll be out next Friday, the 27th.
That's dope.
Yeah,
because I know every single word.
Yeah.
But like that song, More Than Enough, and like Awaken, like I love Awaken. We're gonna talk about Awaken in a second. But I love Awaken. Mm-hmm. Like I would love to see that revisited too. But that's dope. Yeah. Okay, cool.
And then I've got like a lot of new stuff I'm sitting on because I'm transitioning to Nashville. I didn't want to start something in Memphis and then get different resources and want to redo something, so I'm just taking my time because I want the next project to, like, I want to love every bit of it and like put out like my best that I can. So I'm just trying to be patient with it, but I'm excited for what's coming because it's different because I've developed more over the last year. So
So we're gonna put a pin in Nashville because we still want to come back to Nashville. I want to talk about the EP. So she dropped the EP, you said you were 17?
Yeah, 17? I would have been 17, almost 18.
When she was 17, almost 18 years old, Home EP. And I wanted to talk, like, I love, it's 6 songs. It's like one of the, I listen to it all the time. Back when, like, I, because I, how did it, you added me on Facebook a long time ago, and then that's when I found, like, okay, she's a singer. And then I started listen. I found that one project, and then I found it on Apple Music, and I spammed the heck out of it. I listened to it like every single day, rainy days, shiny days, whatever days, and I listened to it. And I always wanted to ask you, like, what's the writing process? Like you said, the EP was kind of rushed. What's your writing process just in general? And just, you could talk about the project, but what's your writing process in general when it comes to writing music?
So in general, so nowadays I'll kind of just be playing on the guitar. Like if I learn certain jazz chords that I really like right now, I'll just play around with them and then kind of add lyrics later, or I'll have a concept for a song, and then once I get the chords, I'll be like, okay, let's break down this concept and write a song to it. My songs tend to, I hate leaving them unfinished, so I tend to just get it all done if it's 3 a.m, like, I want it done, and then I'll come back and fix, like, little things, like, oh, like, let's make that better, but I like to get it done in one sitting, just because that's when it's overflowing, and if I don't do it then, it'll be kind of slow to come back to it.
Now, do you get the chords at the same time, or how do the chords come about? Because I'm so, since you play guitar,
nowadays it kind of I don't know, like, I think the words and the concept come first, and then I'll just play around with new stuff I've learned. Like the very last song that I wrote like a week ago, I started on piano actually. And I don't ever play piano out, but I'll use it for like my own stuff when I'm writing, but just to kind of get a different vibe, because I was kind of like, oh, okay, I'm playing these chords, like, I want to like get a totally different vibe for this song. And so it just really varies. There's no like one formula to it for me. It kind of just varies.
So how many instruments do you play?
I just play guitar, and then piano, I would say I play, like, I wouldn't play for anybody else. Like, I'm not about to just, like, do something crazy, but,
Okay. And then, too, also, you said, so Only You was your favorite song on that EP, right? Or was it, what's your favorite song on that EP?
They all mean a lot to me. Like, Wait For Me, I got to sing for someone's wedding. Awaken's very important to me from my high school perspective. Like, Only You was just so exciting to write. It was like one of the first ones that I wrote. I want to say it was probably the first one for that project that I wrote, and I got to sing it at my youth group, and like, it was just one of those like exciting songs. And Home was like interesting. That one was written on the spot during like a worship time at my youth group. We kind of ran out of songs. We kept singing them over and over. I went back to my mentor. I was like, what do we do now? Like, people have been here for hours. And she's like, go sing a new song. And I was like, what? Like, that's a thing? Like, I can just go there? So then that was the first time I'd ever done that. And Home, the chorus just came out. And then I went right back to my seat and like sang it into my phone. And I was like, I don't know what this is, but I'll come back to it.
I've put that on these weekly episodes that I do. I put that as one of the keys. Like when you're like improving every single day or recording, like artists will use the voice memos.
I have like 400. Like when I get a new phone, it's terrible because you can't really.
You have to email them all to myself.
It's terrible.
It's like, so you utilize the voice memos and the notes, or both?
Mainly voice memos and the notes on like my computer, but.
Sometimes be in the shower, I'm like, okay, I need to go ahead and put that in the phone as soon as I get out.